Hello friends, in this session we will discuss neural control and coordination. So that will be very important to transmit the signal from one area to another area among the nervous system in our body. So in this session I will give that introduction part. So first of all, the coordination. So generally in the nervous system, the neuron, structural and functional unit of nervous system, is nothing but the neuron. So neuron playing a major role to transmit the signals from one area to another area through the whatever the neurons, the entire system in our body, especially the nervous system, that will be transmitting through the neurons one area to another area through the signals. So we will be discuss upcoming videos more information on those topics. So in this session, the coordination nothing but a process two or more organs interact, complement the functions of one another. So here interacting each other among the whatever the functions, if you want to required among the complement to each other, two more organs, it will be cooperating and transmitting the signals and other functions also to perform the body very effectively. So that coordination might be required among the different kinds of systems in our body. So here, let us take example, the physical exercise, how it will be affecting the coordinating manner, more and less heart beat as well as the oxygen supply. So suppose if anybody doing the physical exercise, if anybody or any person started the physical exercise, so at the time, so we need more energy demand, so towards the body. So for the increasing of that will be leads to increased muscular activity. Increased muscular activity. Whenever the physical exercise started, the person, we need more energy demand. So that automatically increased muscular activity. So that's why we need more oxygen supply. More oxygen supply also we need towards the muscle and other body organs, whatever cooperating to do the physical exercise for the body. So at the time, oxygen supply will be increased. That will be whenever oxygen supply will be increasing. So automatically the rate of respiration also increases. Rate of respiration also it will be increased. Whenever oxygen supply, if you want to do properly the muscles, the physical exercise of the body. So automatically whenever the expecting the muscles more energy. So we need the oxygen supply. Whenever the oxygen supply if we want, so automatically respiration also increase. Automatically increase the heartbeat also, we need to pump the blood more effectively because of that blood playing a major role to transport the oxygen towards each and every tissues areas up to the lost levels in our body, so that the heartbeat also increasing. And whenever the heartbeat will be increased, automatically increase the blood flow via blood vessels. So that's why, so that will be leads to in coordinating manner each and everything will be more activate if once the person started the physical exercise. So next, if physical exercise is stopped, so slowly if the person has been stopping the physical exercise, what will happen? Slowly all these organs function will be slowly come down because of the necessity based all these coordinating manner it will be affecting. So activities of the nerves, lungs, heart, kidney gradually return to their normal conditions. So based upon the requirement, based upon the whatever the requirement is there, based upon that all the organs will be activating as well as the slowly gradually return to their normal conditions. So let us come to here the neural system as well as the endocrine system coordinating each other and integrate all the activities of the organs. So not only these neural system and endocrine system, all the systems whatever present in the body, so all are cooperating manner, but in this case neural control and coordination point of view, the neural system and the endocrine system we are talking. So this will be transmitting the signals. The endocrine system nothing but hormones. Hormone, endocrinology nothing but explaining about the hormones. So what is the hormone? Hormone is a chemical substance. Hormone is a chemical substance which is produced in one part of the body and transferred to the distant target area where the function will be fulfilled. So many more glands also there. So those glands will be secreting their respective hormones and that will be also playing a major role to fulfill the function. So these two are coordinating manner. It will be functioning and integrate all the activities of the organs. So then finally leads to their function
in the synchronized fashion. So each and everything coordinating manner, the two systems, it will be coordinating themselves. And here the neural system main function is point to point quick coordination. So through the neural system, the point to point transmitting the signals very, very quickly. So whereas in the case of endocrine system, hormones playing a major role. So we need a mediator, the blood acting as a mediator, and other fluids also acting as mediators. The small quantity of the hormone, it will be slowly going and reach to the target site area. So it may not come reverse, but in the case of neural system, the transmitting signal, it will come back to the starting position area. So like that, the endocrine system chemical integration through hormones, it will be performing. So whereas here, the neurons playing a major role in the neural system, as well as in the endocrine system, hormones playing a major role to transmit the whatever the message or to the target site area. These two are interlinked in the coordinated manner to integrate cell, integrate all the activities of the organs. So this will be the introduction part about that neural control and coordination. Thank you very much.